Hey guys on YouTube, it's Laundromat back again. Tonight I've got for you this LG Turbo Drum Direct Drive 8 kilo top loader washer. I think these sort of early 2000s, mid 2000s, these came out. It's the Direct Drive system, quiet and durable washing, total care programs, big wash 8 kilo. Model number WTR800. Excuse me, we've got a similar model, but it has a glass lid. And it's a 15 kilo model that we got from someone who imported it from South Africa with the matching dryer. But this one we've picked up in Australia, in Perth. Pretty neat. It's had this Rip Curl Australia sticker added to it. Which we haven't taken off yet, but Rip Curl is like a surfing brand, so you know, the machine itself is a bit weathered, you know, this lid is a bit cracked up. The unique thing about this one is it is a fixed turbo drum, so it's got no agitator. The whole drum is the agitator. As you can see, there's no gap there between the agitator fin and the bottom of the bowl. It's all one mounted piece. So yeah, it's pretty unique. So the whole drum agitates back and forth to wash the clothes, and it does wave force spins during the washes and rinses as well. Tonight I'm going to wash some whites. I'm going to wash some whites with some white socks, white towels, white socks, and we are going to use a heavy wash with a heavy soil level. I'm contemplating doing a soak. We're going to use a hot warm wash temperature, and the agitation on this machine seems to do better when you use a lower water level than you would maybe think, but anyway, I will get loaded and away we will go. Okay, we're all loaded up. So tonight we're going to use one of these Tide nanopods, Aerial nanopods, got the brand wrong. You know, if you're not familiar with these, they're big doses of powder from the United Arab Emirates in these dissolvable pouches. Smells very retro, very classic Aerial. So in that goes. Put it there. Okay. Now the trick with this machine is, I'll turn it on, to let it select its own water level and then adjust it. Because for some reason, when you let it select its own water level, that lets it do a hot fill properly. Whereas if you select your own water level, even though you've got it set to hot, it mixes the fill for some reason. Not sure why. But heavy, I'll have the beeper up to high. Use a heavy cycle. We're going to put the temperature up to hot warm. And we'll let it select its own level. Oh, there we go. Chosen an extra large level, which is not accurate. So we're going to go between small and medium for that. And we're going to add on a soak and see what that does. So that's bumped the time up considerably, but I've got time for this load, so it's fine. Hot, warm, heavy. Yep, looks good to me. All right. Where's that pot? Oh, there it is. For some reason that's giving me a cold fill, which is not ideal. So we're just going to redo this because it does my absolute annoys me, we're not going to do soak. Let it select its level. And we will restart it and just make it. There we go. That's better. Yeah, for some reason, some settings mean that you get a cold wash, but I just want a hot wash, and then I will set it to soak once it's filled. I think it's to make use of the bioenzymes and stuff like that, but yeah. Alright, I'll come back when it's filled. I've added some centipedes in there. Just these. In Australia, we've got a supermarket called Coles, and their brand of softener is Amira. I've got these centipedes. Probably enough water, to be honest. Awesome that actually is. People are thinking, oh, nothing's really moving. It does get into it. It does half a wave force. Oh no, maybe slightly smaller, shorter strokes. There you go, that's the balloon. Love that. How fast that thing is whipping back and forth. It must have a good motor. Right. It won't do a full wave force, it'll just do half a one. See? It's only like half a one. When it does the full ones, it's flowing over the top, but you'll see that later. I'm going to set this to soak, and I will come back. I'll leave this open for about 45 minutes once I've done it. But that is blooming the beautiful there. All right, we're back on washing. So the heavy cycle that I've set it to does two deep rinses, as well as a long wash. Everything is going through the water, everything's moving nicely. Can't really argue with that. are doing the bleach wash. So it's in the final few minutes of the wash. Here we go for a big wave, of course. As it's washing the bleach, to make sure it's properly dispersed. Does that for a good 2 minutes. I just caught the tail end of the bleach flush. You've got to love that action. Spin. It now sits for a bit, just to let the clothes drip off for a bit before it goes into the spin. I'll come back when it's finished this bit, because it's a bit of a wait. And spin. questions. I'm going to up the water level a bit, just so that we see it with a bit more of a bigger level. And this. See, the higher level does affect it somewhat, but the clothes are still moving around. They're actually missing away quite nicely there. I've added a little bit of laundry cleanser into the first rinse. Air force. Good way to rinse. Thank you. the second interim spin. Second spin.
Thank you.
Strain 4, final spin. Final spin. Goes to about 800 RPM. Perfect. Looks very clean. Thanks, guys. I'll see you in the next one.